I'm honored to lead the debate on the general principles of the National Frontier Basin Exploration Agency. Mr. President, the bill was first read for the first time on the floor of the Senate on the 16th of April 2013. The objective of this bill, Mr. President, is to provide for the establishment of the National Frontier Basin Exploration Agency to execute, promote, and oversee exploration activities in the inland cemetery basins and for other related matters. Mr. President, it is a matter of common knowledge that petroleum, oil and gas, is currently the mainstay of the nation's economy, and it accounts for about 90% of Nigerian foreign earnings, and has remained a major supporter of its economy since it was first discovered in commercial volume in 1956. Globally, Mr. President, petroleum as an energy source is a cardinal content of world energy demand. The role of Nigeria is of great importance as a contributor to this sector of the world economy. Therefore, as a country, it is imperative to continue to search for more oil and gas to add to our reserve if we are to maintain our lead as the major producer of oil in the world. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, the bill has as part of its objective the promotion of efficient, sustainable exploration of hydrocarbons in the frontier basin of Nigeria, the evaluation of all unassigned concessions in Nigeria, and to undertake, Mr. President, activities that will stimulate exploration interests of local and international oil companies towards increasing the country's oil and gas reserves. The Niger Delta Basin is a mature exploration and producing basin. Like in all other Nigerian cemetery basins, acreages have been delineated in the Niger Delta Basin, and operating licenses on acreages have been continually issued. However, Mr. President, some have entertained the fear that Nigeria has to explore more frontiers for oil in order to avert the financial challenges that may arise from its economy as more and more wells in the Niger Delta begin to record a consistent decline in their output. In addition, Mr. President, to the Niger Delta Basin, is the fact that that current production of petroleum is derived from Niger Delta Basin, but is on the decline. Nigeria is blessed, Mr. President, with numerous other cemetery basins, comprising Anambra Basin, Bida, Sokoto, Bruno, Chad, Dahomey Basin, as well as the Benue Trough, made up of the lower, middle, and upper Benue Trough. These basins, Mr. President, have structural and stratigraphically similarities with contiguous intratonic rifted basins of Niger Republic, Chad Republic, and Sudan, where commercial oil accumulations have been discovered. The agency will function, Mr. President, to regulate exploration of exploration activities in all unassigned frontier acreages in Nigeria, namely, maybe, Anambra, Benue, Tuff, Bida, Chad, Dahomey, Sokoto, Atkeleri, and some in Bauchi. The agency will identify opportunities and increase information about the petroleum resources based within all frontier acreages in a cost-effective manner and with demonstrable technical and operational excellence. The agency shall be expected to generate exploration data on the frontier basin and mature them for detailed exploration by itself on behalf of government and on behalf of multinational and indigenous operating companies. The idea is to look beyond the prolific Niger Delta Basin and extend the search to some other basin with good sedimentation and robust tectonic history, such as the Anambra, Benue, Benin, Chad, Dahomey, Bida, Gongola, Sokoto, and such other basins as may be determined in the future. It is instructive to note that oil finds have since been made in the Gongola Basin of the Upper Benue Trough and in the Anambra Basin, respectively, among others. Mr. President, I profoundly believe that if oil could be found in Niger Republic and Ghana, it is possible that we can discover oil in northern Nigeria. This venture will also present an equal opportunity for all parts of the country, Mr. President, to contribute to reserve from oil to the national coffers. The bill ensures that the proposed agency will work to guarantee many successes of oil, of crude oil from different parts of Nigeria, that is, from Niger and from Niger State to Adamawa to Anambra to Ogun State and other parts of the country. Therefore, I entertain no doubt, Mr. President, in my mind, that with oil exploration in the north and towards the southeast, the attendant economic activities that will arise, therefore, will check the high level of poverty in the country, but more importantly, in the northern region. In the past couple of months, Mr. President, the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, NNPC, has intensified the search for commercial hydrocarbon deposits in Nigeria's inland basins. This follows directly from from President Goodluck Jonathan to the corporation to put more vest into frontier exploration. The directive is in line with his administration aspiration to achieve increased crude oil production capacity and a booster for the nation's reserve of oil and gas from its current level of 37 billion barrels and 187 trillion cubic feet of gas. NNPC remains hopeful of hitting oil in this basin, Mr. President. This is hinged on its belief that available new technologies will yield results where previous exploratory efforts have failed. Also, Mr. President, oil discoveries in commercial quantities in basins located in countries like Chad, Niger Republic, and Sudan, with similar geological formation, have continued to make the NNPC hopeful that oil can be discovered more in northern Nigeria. Discovery, Mr. President, made in Dobwa, Dose, and Bongo in Chad all have the potential of over 2 billion barrels of oil reserve, and Tamit Gadem Basin in the Niger Republic has the potential to hold over 1 billion barrels of crude oil reserve. Regarding the issue of exploiting new technologies to the maximum, lessons should be learned from how the IOC, that is the International Oil Companies, are rising to the challenge of growing world oil demand. They are unlocking previously unreachable deep water oil and gas deposits in high-risk areas like the ultra-deep frontiers with cutting-edge technology. Without technologically advances, these expeditions would not have been made possible. Exploration of the inland basin is worth giving a push, Mr. President. This, of course, will increase the country reserves and boost productivity and export. And all these will have their direct economic and strategic benefit for the country. But more importantly, Mr. President, is the fact that every part of this country will be given the opportunity of getting the God-given mineral resources being exploited. Finally, Mr. President, esteemed colleagues, in the light of the foregone explanation, I urge you all to consider this bill for both its economic and its political benefit to our nation. Assalamu alaikum.